This is the idyllic village of Datchet, near Windsor Castle, but also near the River Thames. And that's why you see this amount of flooding, like you see in many villages up and down the Thames. There has been more rain in the last month here in the UK than there has been since 1776. And so there's really nowhere for the water to go except in some of these villages, in this case, inside of this hotel, this pub. They have been attempting to pump the water out for days. They've stuck a second hose out of the window. This is a place you would see weddings taking place, but at the moment, there's very little business that can take place. The shops in this side of town have been hit particularly hard. You can see this dry cleaner has been trying to get the water out. Have the sandbags worked at all?
No, they came all too late, I'm afraid.
Yeah.
They weren't coordinated, and what we got arrived after the flood, so.
Have you had serious damage, or is it just damage you think you can repair?
I think everything's repairable. We've got, obviously, the other shops here to worry about as well. It's a shame we couldn't have a coordinated line of bags put in before the water came in.
It's not just some of the roads that have been closed and flooded. You see here the train tracks through Datchet have been closed, and I found these two gentlemen standing here.
I was supposed to be in Frankfurt all week, and then watching TV on Monday morning in Germany, I saw that there was my house going by. So it was a case of trying to get the best possible flight out and see what we can save from what's left.
One thing that's very clear here in Datchet is community spirit, something we've seen in other villages as well. This man has been taking people to the pharmacy using his boat and taking them across to dry land. So you're the local vicar and you've been using the services of the man with the boat.
Well, actually, it's the first day I've actually done it. Up till now, I've been walking all the way around the side of the water, but I needed to get to some houses across there, yeah.
And what are people telling you when you go to their houses?
I think the main thing is that people are worried about what will happen. They're trying to make sure they can prepare as best as they can. A few houses have actually got flooded into the living area, but a lot more, the water's lapping around the front doors, so they're naturally worried.
This is a scene repeated many times here in the center of the village of Datchet. The military moving personnel through here. They built some ramparts over the weekend into Monday to try to keep the water from rising too high here. To the great relief of residents, I'm sure, this pharmacy has remained open. Despite the sandbags, it has remained dry, which is allowing people to come in and get the medicine they need.
It's been a bit of a struggle, even with deliveries, even with the staff coming in, but because the water is just up until knee-high, as long as we have our wellies, we're able to come in.
And there's the man with his canoe who's been helping the pharmacy and those who need to get their medicine. I have to say that the water has receded during the day, but the wind has picked up and the rain has begun again. I imagine he and the emergency services and the military are going to remain quite busy in the next few days. Jim Bolden, CNN, Datchet, England.